All right. Did I get my email?
I have not had anything happen yet. On my various devices, will say things.
Oh, I got my email.
I got my Twitch push notification, and people are saying that things are happening.
Things are happening!
This shouldn't be so surprising, but, you know, internet.
Yeah, well, ever since I switched our streaming server to a different one, everything has been fine. So I think it was just that server was just no good.
Or maybe that's a default, and so everyone uses it, and it gets a little overloaded.
It was definitely not the default, because I explicitly chose it when I first started up Game Show to pick the one that was most geographically close to me, because that was what
they
recommended.
That's not always sensible.
It's not always sensible, and so I have since switched. I think I'm actually streaming out of one in Canada now.
Sweet.
So, yeah. Good times. What's up, faithful stream watchers and listeners?
It's been so long since our last stream, a whole week.
It honestly feels much longer to me.
To me too, for some reason.
Because I have been on 4 planes and worked a show since then.
I think it feels longer to me because I've been busy.
Yes.
Making things.
Making things and stuff.
Been down in the code mines.
Cytosine says, there's a tool you can use to test Twitch server response times. Good thing to run every now and again. Yes, I don't remember if I actually used, when I contacted Game Show support saying like, hey, our thing is busted, what up? They gave me a bunch of things to do. And so I tried all of them and, I didn't try all of them. I tried some of them and then I tried switching our hosting server and everything has been working swimmingly ever since then.
Richard says he can't see anything, but, you know, you're obviously showing all the secrets off right now. So
yes,
you just didn't want to say anything.
If you guys didn't get here right at 7, you missed the big secret reveal, and it's too bad because we're not going to repeat it.
Yep.
We wouldn't do that to you. Yeah, the only thing that you should be seeing on the screen right now is our usual, this is the game. Here, I'll put the online multiplayer. There you go. Oh, there's the big secret. There's a new game button in
it's amazing.
Multiplayer. Woohoo!
I think that's actually, that little change is going to make a big difference because we get some complaints from people, they sit on this screen waiting for the game to appear, and, that's not how you get into a game. How you get into a game is you start a game and wait for people to join you.
Yes.
Because you could have 1,000 people sitting there waiting. And if no one presses create game, then nothing will happen.
Exactly. But here we are on... that's one of the little new bits that's in the build that we're currently working on. But that's not the most important thing. We'll get to the most important thing in just a moment. But before that, I wanted to mention to everybody that it's Tuesday. It's 7-ish. So that, of course, means it's time to welcome you all to Sentinels Live! Thanks for joining us around the digital tabletop while we play what, John?
I didn't know you're going to be doing that every time. Sentinels of the Multiverse.
Sentinels of the Multiverse. The
Just
goal
like
of these
whenever
streams...
Whenever you start your thing, it's time for me to start having a drink.
Ah, nice. whenever Jeremy tries to make John say something that he wasn't expecting to say, take a shot. Thanks for joining us around the digital tabletop while we play Sentinels of the Multiverse. The goal of these streams is to have fun, which we usually do. I don't know. I can't remember a stream that I didn't have fun, honestly. While also showing you how to play the game, as well as covering some strategies that might help you win. At Handelabra, we believe in being as inclusive as possible. So any comments, activity, or other things actively working against that goal is just simply not welcome and won't be tolerated. We are not afraid to use the ban hammer if we must. As we are the developers, you can also be sure to get some insight into the development process and maybe, just maybe, see something before anyone else, which you will tonight. I'm just going to let that sink in for a minute. The game does include a tutorial that covers the basics, but we always do our best to explain exactly what we're doing, when we do it, and why when it comes to strategy. And depending on how long it takes for us to win or lose, we often... play more than one full game in a session. And our episodes are usually somewhere from an hour to 2 hours. Usually somewhere around the hour and a half mark is usually the average. Sentinels of the Multiverse is currently available for iPad, Android, tablets, as well as PC, Mac, and Linux via Steam, and always via good old analog cardboard. And you can get more info about the game at sentinelsdigital.com. So as somebody was asking, all I see is the normal, regular card, and that's what you see here now, but that's actually not what we're going to be playing on tonight. Tonight, we're going to be playing on something a little bit different, and that is this. That's right. Handelabra Games now streaming Sentinels of the Multiverse, the video game, for smartphones. What?
Ba-na-na.
Mind blown. So we did promise you that this was coming as part of the Kickstarter, and we have been working diligently on it since the Kickstarter closed, and it is now to a point where we're ready to show it off. It's not done, but it's getting pretty close. So yeah, and I considered putting like a skin on it so you could see like how it looks in the middle of the phone screen, but it's not what it. It's just streaming right off of my phone. I got it all plugged in, and you can see it. So we're going to show you how it works tonight. We also toyed with the idea of having a video showing me actually, like, touching it so that you could see exactly how it looks, like, in your hand. But maybe for next week. I didn't have time to get a whole thing all worked out to make that a thing. So I think John started a game. So let's pop into online multiplayer here.
I think you're playing it on an iPhone SE, right?
Tonight I'm actually playing on the Handelabra phone, so this is a 6S.
Cool.
That I am playing this on right now.
The Cadillac.
Exactly. It's the Cadillac of beers. Are you in the Freedom 582?
I am.
All right, so I'm going to join John in Freedom 582.
You're ready already.
And here we are. That's so weird. There's Handelabra Games with the little wagelings, and of course we got Migrant P, who's the king. So let's walk around this screen for a minute. Actually, since I'm not the host, you're not going to get to see me select the villain. But that's okay. I can still pop up the villains so we can see.
Sure.
Actually, when I scroll, it makes the audio twitchy. I hope that doesn't happen the whole time. But so here's where you pick from your villains, and we can pop in here, and you can look at the environments. So yeah, you'll notice that the selection in this is a little bit different. On the iPad and on Steam, we've got a lot of big, wide open screen space, but on a phone, you got to be a little bit more industrious with your use of space. So we've come up with this sort of like two-step process for. Oh, look at this! It's still got skyscraper selected from when I played earlier. Actually, you know what? Just to be on the safe side, I am going to quit out of that and restart it, just because it's been literally sitting there running all day. All right, so let's pop back in again. Online multiplayer, Freedom 582.
Yeah, there was something funny. You popped in and showed as ready.
Yep, that was... Oh, no, the sound is still doing that same thing. Well, hopefully that won't happen during the game.
Just don't scroll very much.
Yeah, I'll try not to scroll if I can avoid it. All right, so yeah, so this is... you can see the chat. We'll pop open the chat here for a second. Let's type, we'll say, hi, John. Doot-doot. Doot-doot. So there's that. All right, so what's he talking about? I will have a one on your screen at all times. Oh, John. And then here's your, yeah, see, scrolling this doesn't happen. You know what I think it is? I think it's just because when you scroll the decks, that's a lot of graphics to have in one screen.
Yeah, it's all coming down the same pipe.
Yep. All right, so... what should we play tonight? Let's take two heroes, and then I'll randomize on those two heroes. And I got Grandpa nice. Legacy and Freedom 6 Tachyon. And then we'll see what John comes up with, or the stream comes up with, for us to play.
You want random, or do you have something in mind?
I have nothing in my mind. So this weekend I was at a really cool show called RTX. That's the Rooster Teeth Expo. And that was down in Austin, Texas. We talked to a lot of old and new Sentinels fans. I did want to do a quick shout out. Two of our volunteers were two of the best volunteers we've ever had. That's Scott and Broccoli. I believe his real name, his IRL name is Brian. He's one of the playtesters. He's been playtesting Sentinel since way, way, way back. And he did, both of them were really just amazing at showing off the game, playing with, you know, new people, showing them how it works on the tabletop, showing them how it works on the Steam. It was a really terrific show. We had a great time. We sold lots of Sentinel stuff, and we introduced a lot of new people to the world of the multiverse. So that's good stuff.
All right, we should try sort of, how about we do like a mini challenge mode, Spite, Agent of Gloom, and Skinwalker Gloomweaver set.
Ooh, sure.
And so we can keep the same team, but we won't do a reset. Which environment do you want to play in?
There's been a request for Omnitron 4. I feel like we've played a lot of Omnitron 4 lately, just because it's the newest. I don't know. What's a good environment for that matchup? I mean, Realm of Discord, I think, is pretty thematically sound, right? Isn't Gloomweaver kind of the Realm of Discord guy?
Yeah. But, I mean, they can... And there's also, obviously, Rook City, but that's probably a bad idea. Silver Gulch is fun. I'm always up for Silver Gulch.
I am always up for Silver Gulch. I have no problem with that.
All right. And I think we should choose heroes. Carefully. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe not so carefully. I'm going to take guys because I like guys. And... The Scholar. Did I play the Scholar last week? I'm trying to remember. Maybe I did.
I think I played the Scholar last week. Although, to be fair, I played about 100 games of Sentinels this weekend, so I could be misremembering.
I guess Night Mist should probably be on this team. So I'm going to do that.
All right.
I think this is a pretty good team. So it's been a while since we played Spite. Do you want to pull up the card?
Sure. So Spite, Agent of Gloom. At the start of the game, Spite enters play Agent of Gloom's side up. All five drug cards from the villain deck are put face down in the villain play area. The safe house card is put into play. The villain deck is shuffled. Gameplay, at the start of the villain turn, if there are H cards under the safe house, Spite flips. If not, flip a face down villain card face up. Whenever a lab raid would enter play, instead it is discarded and Spite deals each hero target 2 melee damage. At the end of the villain turn, Spite deals the hero target with the highest HP, H infernal damage. If there are more cards under the safe house than face up drugs, a drug card is flipped face down. And face down villain cards are indestructible. Actually, should I flip them over? I guess I can flip them over.
And so we're going to play advanced. At the end of the villain turn, a face down villain card is flipped face up.
Oh boy. And on his flip side, he is the Broken Vessel. Increased damage dealt by Spite by 1 for each card under the safe house. Whenever a card is placed under the safe house, one player may draw a card. Whenever a victim is destroyed, Spite deals each hero target 1 psychic damage. Whenever a lab raid would be played, instead it is discarded, and Spite deals each hero target 2 melee damage. At the start of each hero turn, that player may remove a card from under the safe house and put it into play. If they do, they may play a card. At the end of the villain turn, Spite deals the hero target with the lowest HP, H minus 1 melee damage. Face down villain cards are indestructible and advanced. At the end of the villain turn, a victim is destroyed. Crazy.
I don't know what's happened. Some Silverleaf said I'm a bad person, and Morph said that I made his wife cry with sadness. What did I say? I don't remember.
Oh, no.
Oh. All right, let's do this. We want open hands. And I think that's it.
All right.
Maybe because I picked Spite, that's probably why.
Yeah, check out this new opening. Ooh.
That's right. New opening animation just for phone.
Oh, yeah, that scrolling animation is also messing with the sound. The actions you take become your own legacy. Stand proud. All right, let's take a look at what we all start with. Looks like Legacy starts with Heroic Interception, Motivational Charge, Surge of Strength, and Legacy Ring. Guys starts with Guys the Barbarian, Retcon, and Say Cheese. Oh, good, I can test that. or I can watch you test it. Accelerated Assault, HUD Goggles, Lightspeed Barrage, and Synaptic Interruption for Team Leader Tachyon. And Night Mist starts with Call Forth, Enlightenment, Tome of Elder Magic, and Tome of Elder Magic. So the first thing you'll probably notice here is the screen is obviously laid out a little differently. We've kept everything in play order so that it's clear what's happening. I accidentally hit start game, so all those drugs came out face down. But so you got your villain on top, then you got your heroes in a row below them. So it's still kind of the same thing that you're used to. You can see them all in order. And then the environment is way at the bottom there. One of the things you'll notice, though, that is one of the sort of innovations that we came up with to make this a little bit easier to play is that you're used to having full cards as well as like what we call small card, or I guess some people might call them mini cards. But now we have micro cards where you can see at a glance what's happening in the villain play area there. It looks like you've got 5 face down cards that are like just little tiny things. And then based on the artwork, you can figure out what else we've got going on, which is the safe house and potential sidekick. So if you ever need to see what that is, you can always tap on that area and bring it up full, but so that you can always have at a glance what's happening, you can see those little micro cards with the artwork in them.
So Morph's wife is sad because Sentinels is going to be on Morph's phone.
Ah.
And he'll be busy. And Silverleaf was sad because I'm going to try to keep that message bubble at a 1. And that bothers her.
Yes. Doo-doo. All right. So let's go back to meanwhile and see what was happening here. So we get to select a card to face flip up. Flip face up.
Question mark, what is the lightning bolt on some of the cards? The lightning bolt lets you toggle the effects displayed on the cards. Like, I think Safe House has one if you bring it up. You can tap the lightning bolt if you want to see the artwork, because some of them have lots of effects and they can get covered up.
Yeah, so this is what we call, our internal name for this is special strings, right? Isn't that what these are?
Yeah.
Yeah, and so this is where, like, okay, let's say you've got, just to pick a random example, Tachyon. Tachyon has X burst cards in her trash. If you bring up Lightspeed Barrage, you'll see, oh, Tachyon has X number of, you know, cards in her trash. There we go. Tachyon's trash has no burst cards. But there are other cards that can have, like, a huge listing of stuff in this, which could go all the way down and cover up the whole card. A good example of that might be something like Captain Cosmic, where it's like, destroy all... constructs. Destroy all constructs in play. And the special string can actually list off all the constructs that are in play, which could potentially get fairly large. So that's a way to turn that off so that you can actually see what's happening. All right, what should we flip face up? I like going for the middle.
Sure.
What do we get?
We got PL. Compound Upsilon.
Upsilon. Increased damage dealt by Spite by 1. All right. First player to draw a card.
I actually like this card with Guys because he can keep his things that would otherwise get destroyed at the start of his turn. Oh, and we all get to draw cards.
Lead from the front. Motivational charge. Yeah, I don't think that this issue with the audio is because of the animation. I think it's because of the way that Game Show is trying to stream it right off the phone.
Okay.
That would be my guess.
No one's complaining. Maybe it's just
except
something
me.
You're hearing. All right. So we have to flip another one up because of advanced. Demon's Kiss. It's going to hit us all. They hear it. Some crackling.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see.
Do I want to discard 3 cards? Let's see what I have. I have 2 more
no,
additional charges.
Keep sidekick around. It's the best.
Yeah.
I have to leave this little kid dangling. And we actually, well, the thing is, like, with Advanced Spite, it's going to be, like, impossible to
stay ahead
from drugs. So, yeah, we need to get 4 under the safe house. That's not going to happen. and we need more under the safe house than face up. So I think let's just forget about the victims and smash Spike.
Just make the hard choices. All right, so let's see. We've already taken a little bit of a beating.
I'm definitely okay with Drick Legacy.
So, like, maybe, like, motivational charge and just heal everybody?
Yeah. Well, you can have yourself use motivational charge, right? That's Jerk Legacy.
Yes, when you use it on yourself. So we'll heal one. And we'll motivational charge, hit Spite. Heal again. Everybody else will heal.
Right.
So Handelabra is streaming Sentinels like PBS shows fireworks. Yeah, that's about how they apparently, I don't know what they did, but they did something where they were showing like not the current live one because the sky was actually nicer than it actually was in DC or something. I don't know. So based on the answer that someone's giving, I assume someone further up in the chat asked, will you be able to cross-play? Yes, phone playing with tablet, phone playing with PC, phone
it's
playing with everything.
Right now.
Yeah, John's playing on Steam, I'm playing on phone.
What do I want to do? I think I want to actually draw a card. Ooh, best card ever. Play it from your computer?
Yeah, I'm going to play it from iTunes. Let me know if you guys are hearing that music. You might not be. Oh, yes, they are. Okay, good. All right, good. So that's good. And now the sound effects will come from the phone, but the music will just be playing through iTunes. All right, so...
There's a question. Will guys know what platform he's playing from and adjust dialogue accordingly? Of course, guys knows what platform he's playing on, but none of his dialogue has to do with which particular platform you're on.
Yes. Do I want to? No, we've already decided we're not going to do this. Okay, so I have no burst cards in my trash, and based on what I've got, I'm definitely going to HUD goggles. And I mean, I assume with Spite, we're just trying to knock him out as fast as possible, so even just the accelerated assault is probably worth it. Unless
sure.
I should Synaptic Interruption.
I mean, Synaptic Interruption is good, too.
Yeah, I'm going to do that, and I'll save that for later, and let's see what else we get. So let's draw a card with Team Leader. We got Back Fist Strike. Let me see that. Accelerated Assault. Mist Form. And there's my Fleet of Foot.
Cool. Man, so many cards. I actually don't have many high magic numbers. Oh, I do have a tome. Okay. I'm going to go looking for some more cards because I want my relics. That's that relic I want. So many stout barrels. C. Cruz asks, how many unique dialogue, special effects, and sound effects does guys have in this game? A lot.
Yeah, that's a good question, actually. I don't know that we have it written. I mean, we definitely have it written down somewhere. I don't know that we've ever counted them.
There are many.
Yes.
There's still I wouldn't say there's many that people haven't found yet, but there's still several that people haven't found.
Yes, there are definitely still a few.
Oh, that drug. The one that hits us when we use a power. All right. We have to return two to hand. I'm thinking probably motivational and HUD goggles.
Yeah, I'm fine with that. Because I have... Well, not that it matters. I was going to say, Harry, I have another one, but this is returning to your hand, not destroying. So yeah. Now I have two.
Draw cards.
Get a Thok. Danger Sense. Retcon. I can do that too. Hypersonic Assault. Lightning Reflexes. Oblivion.
I think I have three retcons in hand. Be crazy if I played them all in a row. All right. Spite.
And this is the advanced, right? Isn't it?
No, this is...
Oh, this is just his thing.
Regular damage. And here I would send it right back to him.
And an explosive barrel.
Ouch, that was actually more. Well, I guess that's because she had the highest. It would have ended up going to guys. Another drug face up. Is he going to destroy the environment? I think you chose correctly. Well, for some value of correctly. All right. I don't know how many more rounds we have at this rate.
Yeah, seriously. I'm picking the phone up. I've mostly been playing it just sitting on its little stand, but I'm going to actually hold it now because I feel like I need to. All right.
That motivational charge wouldn't be a bad play again.
Yeah. I'm going to play the other one this time, though. Who's the lowest? We're all about the same.
If you had Inspiring Presence, I probably would play that instead, but... Actually, you know what? We know he's going to destroy the explosives wagon on his turn. It might be good to have us actually become immune to damage. And also, that just happened, where he hit you for a ton of damage.
All right, so hang on.
Well, whatever. We could do the heroic interception trick where you play heroic interception, and then I copy it, and then we're all immune to damage.
I like it.
You want to do that instead of what you just did?
Yep. All right, so I will heroic interception.
And I would probably skip your power unless you want to take the damage for it. Actually, if you use your power, let me... Oh, no, my card would be destroyed at the start of my turn. That's not as good. It's up to you if you want to use a power, but you'll get hit for 4 damage if you do. For I'm not sure if the benefit is there.
Yeah. So there's some discussion in there. You do not lose the achievements if you use the unlock button. The unlock button is just basically a courtesy. If people are just like, I don't care about achievements. I just want to play with this guy already. And so it lets you do that. But you can still complete the story challenge even after having pushed the button.
So I deal myself 3 damage, but I'm immune to damage. And I'm totally going to play the best card ever.
Harbinger asks, what phone are you playing on? I am playing on an iPhone 6S. And I will tell you this. I know I can see just in game show that it's like chugging and there's still some issues happening with the sound. That is not a result of the phone. It's a result of the way that game show is streaming it, because it's actually pulling it right off the phone via a cable. And it's animating much smoothly on my phone, and then it doesn't look like it on the stream for some reason. So... It actually plays like Buddha.
I wish I could. I wish I had Super Ultra Kawaii or Selling Out, but I don't. But I think I kind of want to put out another card that I can return to my hand so that we don't lose our invulnerability during Spite's turn. So I'm going to put out, let me see that, if there's an equipment I can take, which I don't actually think there is, so it'll just get trashed. All right, then Guys the Barbarian it is, I think. Because I want Total Beefcake for later. Then I can hit Spike for a little more.
Yeah, some discussion about Omnitron U. We did that exactly on purpose. We wanted people to be able to play with it immediately because it was part of the Kickstarter. So we made the button available immediately. But as you say, it does not negate you getting the achievement. So a lot of people were getting it even after, you know, within a week or couple weeks after pushing the button, because that's just the way it's designed. I do not want to discard three cards. I do not want to be dealt damage. All right. Think. Oh, well, I could have done that.
What?
We just prepped ourselves for it. I have Hypersonic Assault. I could Hypersonic Assault the Explosive Wagon.
But don't worry about it this turn.
Yeah, I was going to say, now I don't need to worry about it. If he's going to kill it...
He's definitely going to kill it, so...
Yeah, we've taken care of that. So I think I'm just going to HUD Goggles and then Fleet of Foot.
Well, I would Fleet of Foot, then HUD Goggles, but...
Oh, yeah, I guess that makes sense. Got takedown. Yeah, I'm that guy. Supersonic. Planar banishment. And now I will HUD goggles. And have I been?
Marv asks on behalf of his wife, when will Christopher be on the stream next? I don't know.
That's a good question. I will ask him. And let's get some more cards. Danger Sense. Selling out.
We'll be discarding lots of burst cards, hopefully.
Quick Insight.
Spite's effect.
Scouring Mists. Sonic Vortex.
All right.
I got to tell you, just because these are one of those things that I'll do. I know that you guys have not yet figured out Santa guys, but so many of you are so close. It's almost frustrating to see.
I feel like now is a good time for Oblivion.
Mm.
We're all immune to damage. So that's happening.
What'd you get? 2 and 3? So you're not going to hit. You're not going to kill the thing. I was going to say, if you kill the thing on our turn...
It will kill the thing. There's plus one.
Oh, there's plus one. Oh, good. So, yeah. So, the first hit will be reduced for Spite, but then all the rest of them are going to be full on.
And Spite's the only one who will get hit by the wagon blowing up.
You killed three targets. You must have...
title?
Yeah, a title. I've been playing a lot of Karga lately. I still don't know which title, but... Was that the Indiscriminate? No, Indiscriminate is when you hit more... You hit multiple villain and hero targets in a turn.
I have a lot of cards in my hand. 18 cards in Nightmare's hand.
Nice.
How did that even happen? Well, things are happening. There's lots of card draw.
So some people have been saying that the UI feels small. And one thing to keep in mind is that it's 1920 by 1080, and by which I mean it's 1080 by 1920. And it's going to look smaller on this because it's only like the middle part of your screen. And I think we may also only be streaming at 720p. So it's actually like the resolution is like 1/3 what it actually will be when it's on your phone.
Yeah.
Just keep that in mind.
The sort of the screen size we're targeting as like the main size is like a what's the six iPhone 6, it's a
4.5 inch
screen. No, it's, I don't need 4.7 inch.
Yeah, it's like a, yeah, something like that. 4.7, 4.5.
So that's sort of like the main, we're sort of aiming for it to be almost a little bit too big on that size so that it'll work, still work well on smaller phones like the iPhone 5, and work on, you know, larger like the 6 Plus and Android phones that are, you know, 6 inches or so. So it's definitely a balance, but we're hoping to try to find a good balance. So I think we want Guys of a Brain and Hug Goggles back, and we need the other ones to stay. And then we can have you hypersonic. Oh, I know why I have to drive so many cars, because of this hostage.
Yes.
And everything else, but it's like crazy. I'll have 20 cards in hand on like the third round. All right.
And so I think next week, if we do the phone again, I'm going to have it stream via QuickTime, because I'm really not liking the way it's looking in Game Show, and I'm hoping that that's not...
Okay, maybe that's a streaming issue.
I really do think it is, because like I told you, I was like all excited that Game Show could pull it right off the phone directly without having to go through something else, but I think that QuickTime is going to be the better choice for that.
Do you want to try to reset it in between games?
Yeah, maybe we can do that. I'll launch that now so that it's ready to go.
You are AFK, by the way.
Oh, that's why I went to try and vote, but then it just went without me, and it must have been because I was already AFK. So no. All right, I'm back.
AFT?
Yes.
So no worries about... Well, I mean... You might want Next Evolution, because he's going to hit you if you use a power. That's one thing.
What kind of damage is he doing? Melee?
It's from that drug. So it'll be toxic.
Toxic.
But you could safely play Next Evolution and jerk Legacy Next Evolution toxic to get a hit point, basically. So that's one option.
I'm at 14, everybody else is at 17, 18, and 20.
Because we'll be able to get through a hypersonic assault. Can we get through a hypersonic assault with his damage reduction?
Yeah, the explosive wagon is gone, so we don't have any boost.
Oh, but you have a lightning reflexes, so you can play more than one card. So you can get your hypersonic assault through. You just need...
Right, I just have to deal some damage. Yeah, I just have to deal some damage first. Okay, so let's see here. Where's my thingy? Next evolution. And we'll jerk legacy. That didn't sound great. Toxic.
Discard all the cards.
Yep. Draw heroic interception. And we're on to guys.
Poor victims. All right, so that's the end of, oh yeah, I'm that guy. But I have lots of things to do. So the first thing I'm going to do, I think, is total beefcake.
Don't hate me.
And then I'm going to use my power to play Super Ultra Kawaii. And do zero damage to Spite, but then he total beefcakes right back to his face.
Nice.
And then I can play a card because of Super Ultra Kawaii. I'm going to play... Where did I leave that?
Extreme.
Didn't get what I'm looking for. I want best card ever.
And I do not want to discard three cards. No. I was going to say, I could. I just get three more bursts into my trash with all these cards I got. What do I have in there? Hang on, let's pop this open. I have 5 burst cards. I get to discard both of those. Both of those.
Well, I remember if we want to hit him with Hypersonic Assault, you need to play a damaging. You need to play Lightspeed or Lightning Reflexes and a damage card, and then Hypersonic Assault.
Right. Yeah. Okay. So let's do.
And I mean, you can also play HUD Goggles. Makes sense too.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Like, cause I'm just trying to do the math here. Like, if I discard both Accelerated Assaults, and then like one of the HUD Goggles, or I guess one of the Quick Insights, that would be 3 more burst cards into my trash. Then I can Lightning Reflexes and like Sonic Vortex to get that out of the way, and then Hypersonic Assault him, and then I'm in a better position for the next turn. Let's do that.
I understand. What? Where are you getting this extra card play from? You can't play Quick Insight and deal.
No, not Quick Insight. I'm saying back up to the beginning and discard 3 cards for the guy under the safe house that we were ignoring, but do it anyway just so I can get 3 burst cards into my trash.
I mean, I'd rather continue everyone drawing 2 cards.
All right, fair enough. All right, so all HUD Goggles, Lightning Reflexes, Sonic Vortex, so I can at least get 1 through the damage reduction.
You should target guys.
I was going to say, as soon as I pushed, I was like, wait. All right, back it up. All right, so let's do this again. So HUD Goggles, Lightning Reflexes, Sonic Vortex. We're going to hit him for 1. Then we'll hit guys and bounce it off of his beautiful shimmering chest. Stop dealing damage. And then Hypersonic. Spite cannot deal damage. And then draw all the cards.
Yeah, like having Spite have all of his cards in his hand is kind of the game at some point. You can just do an infinite amount of things. Or not infinite, but ridiculous amount. Alright, I think I want my Geyser Barbarian out at this point, and then next turn I'll play Selling Out at some point. And we'll see how much damage I can do before my turn. No, discard. I've been wanting to play the amulet, but like I have so many other options too. I think the amulet probably makes sense though.
Yeehaw.
Sure, he's gonna soak this, but that's okay. Because guys is gonna be dealing damage. I think I'll start out with best card ever. Gonna play Selling Out right now.
Nice.
A prickly cactus. Oh no! Actually, guys would punch the prickly. Or sorry, Spite is it someone who would hit the prickly cactus? Most things wouldn't, but. Alright, I need to discard. I'm going to discard a gimmicky character. And play a one-shot. I think I can play. I can do that too. Let's see. Nothing really good to copy with, on that guy. But I can play, I can do that too and use Legacy's power. To use Guise's power. And do I want to play a card or draw another card? I feel like I want to draw another card, even though that's kind of crazy.
Who cares? Why not?
Hey, I got another. I can do that too. And I will punch Spite. And Spite cannot damage anyone. Then actually, I'm going to play I can do that too again.
Nice.
And use Nightmist's power to deal 2 damage to myself. Oh, wait. Who could hurt such a beauty? Actually destroys a prickly cactus instead of him. Oh, well. But I got to draw a couple cards. Then I'm going to play Retcon. And I'm going to destroy Selling Out. And that lets me play a card. And I'm going to play Selling Out. Experimentally refreshing.
All right, I'm going to like run to the bathroom while you're looking. Oh, guys.
I actually don't really need all these retcons. But they are, they're good cards. I think I'm going to discard that gimmicky character because I have plenty of hit points. And I'm going to play Say Cheese and actually hit Spite. Everyone's like, holy crap. Yep, that's guys. You can do some pretty crazy things with a lot of cards. And I actually don't want to play Retcon, so I'm going to skip that. I should have retconned that environment card earlier. That was a mistake.
Yeah, if we got rid of the cactus, we could have done another 4 damage to him.
I'm not going to rewind for all that.
Yeah, seriously. All right, how many are we returning to hand? 2?
Right, so here we can return Selling Out.
Yeah.
Easy. And Total Beefcake, because he's not going to do any damage, so.
And then you'll have it.
And then we draw 2 cards. This is gross.
Flying Smash, Next Evolution.
This isn't even getting into, like, if we flipped Spite and the crazy shenanigans that guys can get up to on Spite's flip side with, like, playing cards at the start of your turn and things. So much for this Harbinger of the Gloomweaver. Well, we'll see. He could still do something.
He could still rally. I mean, he's still got 40 hit points, so.
He played a good Samaritan. I'm so afraid.
All right, so I have my next evolution.
Did you pick up another Hypersonic?
I don't think I did. I did not. But I picked up 2 Fleet of Foots. Fleet of Feet? I don't know.
Fleet of Feet. I think we could just, like,
yeah, like, I can him. Yeah, I can, like, Fleet of Foot, pushing the limits. So, yeah, all right. So let's see what we got here. Legacy. All right, what are we thinking about in terms of mitigating damage? Because I have my lead from the front with my next evolution, so I could potentially do that.
Yeah, that's not bad.
I'm saying if we don't want to take the chance, what's going on with Tachyon here? Yeah, I have 1 Hypersonic Assault, but I have 11 cards in my deck, so.
But yeah, I mean, we could just do the Heroic Interception combo again.
Oh, that's true.
We wouldn't even
need to do it, would we? Because I can Heroic Interception and then jerk Legacy into Toxic and...
Well, he also does melee, but... And Infernal.
That's true.
But he doesn't do, like... And he does a bunch of different types, actually. Also Psychic. So, yeah, I mean, why not? The heroic interception is, it works, and it only costs 3 hit points, like, once compared to...
Sure.
Right? And then you can, now you can, like, you can use any power. Like, you could go into Tekion or Geyser, whatever, because you don't need the next evolution part right now. Or you don't need the next evolution because he can't deal damage.
Right.
So, yes. Let's draw more cards.
Because why not? All right. So, I got another lead from the front. I got a blatant reference. Sucker Punch. And Tome of Elder Magic.
So, yeah. Spite is getting all of your burst cards in your trash. You've got 12 in your trash.
So, Bella Sorciere, yes, it's something we've been talking about. Is the issue happens with, it has to do with, I think, how Game Show is pulling the audio off the phone. So I don't know if you're hearing it on my voice or if you're just hearing it on the sound effects. I'm hearing it on the sound effects, and I think it's because of the way Game Show is pulling stuff in off the phone. We're gonna try and switch that before the second game.
I think I'm just going to not play a card because it would only do like one damage due to his damage reduction. You haven't hit him this turn, right? So
I've only hit myself, I think.
Yeah, I'm just going to skip. And then I can do an, oh yeah, I'm that guy. I think. Yeah. Ooh, I can become immune to a damage type of my choice now. And I'm going to play Super Ultra Kawaii. And then at the end of my turn, I can play Look What I Found. That's nice. How convenient.
Oh, man, the look on your face.
Oh, man, the look on your face.
What's my one card in my deck? Best card ever is in my deck. My deck is one card, and it's the best card ever. And you can help me draw it to play at the end of your turn.
There it is.
Sweet.
Have guys shuffle by fleet of footing again. Get fortitude. Say cheese.
Have you gotten pushing the limits yet?
I have a pushing the limits in hand.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, I was gonna fleet of foot, pushing the limits.
And light speed barrage.
Yeah, so if I push the limits now, I still have two card plays.
That's true. So you could do like quick insight if you want to get
yeah,
two
that's
more damage.
I've got 14 in my trash. Yeah, I think I'm gonna quick insight.
Well, I don't quick insight though. He's gonna reset your deck unless you don't. Oh, you got two. Oh, there you go.
Look at that.
That's game. That's game right there. Play both your Lightspeed Barrages.
Well, I only have one more card play.
But you drew a Lightning Reflexes.
Oh, look at that!
I mean, it's not quite game, but it's
yeah,
game.
Yeah, it's essentially game. Oh, down to 5. Yeah, let's draw some more cards. Why not? Takedown. Guy's the Barbarian. Tachyon reshuffles. Wah, wah. Nimble Strike. And Call Forth. All right, what do you think, Night Mist? Can you do 5?
Night Mist has... It's not, Night Mist won't get a turn, I don't think. Night Mist has 27 cards in hand. So guys can play... Say Cheese. That target is still in play and has 5 HP or fewer. So I can play Say Cheese. Just unlocked a variant card.
Nice.
And then I can play best card ever. And that's the end for Spite.
And there it is.
That was pretty awesome.
Yeah, epic Spite game.
This team is ridiculous. Well, I mean, any team that gets to draw two cards every round from that victim.
As soon as I knew that we were going to win, I should have switched me back to the audio coming from the phone, because now we don't get the... Hang on, here we go, here we go. There's the victory music playing from iTunes. Nice. All right, well, when you defeat the Harbinger, you know what you got to do next.
That's right. So do you want to play in the same mode, or do you want to try the quick time thing?
Yeah, let me just do that real quick, because I should be able to do it pretty quickly. So let's turn this off.
My game log. See if I can find it. I'm on Mac, guys. Remember where it is. I have a file that tells me where to look, though.
All right, so let's unplug the phone. Plug the phone back in. Pop open QuickTime Player. Yes, okay, so turn this up and pause that music as it fades out and plug this in, capture, screen capture. I'm just gonna talk you through what I'm doing here. I'm just selecting a different streaming thingy, so. Window, select window.
That's not where my log file is. There's two places that it can appear on the Mac, depending on your version.
Nope, not volume. That's not what I wanted to change. This needs to stay at 100. And sizing.
Oh, right, it's a multiplayer log. That's why I didn't see it.
Fit.
I can talk to myself, too.
Yes.
We can both talk to ourselves.
Good times. All right, so let's go new game.
I don't see my log. Hang on a second. Things are a little funny when it's on your programmer computer.
Yeah, I'll play the Matriarch's music while you're doing that.
I don't see my log. Oh, well, sorry. You guys can just watch the video. There's that. You can watch it on YouTube later and dissect it and see what happened.
All right, turn that off. And actually, I'm going to back out of this multiplayer game for 1 second because I want to...
All right. I unlocked Santa Guys, if you were wondering.
Options.
Apparently, I didn't have him unlocked on this computer for some reason. Things happen.
Good, so that's working, so I can turn off the monitor. I'm getting a weird echo. Why am I getting a weird... Oh, I know why I'm getting a weird echo. But how do I... Oh, I can just turn that off. Awesome. Okay, cool. So let's join up John again.
So is that working better now?
I'll let you know once I can scroll. All right, guys, tell me if you can hear the weird issues. Yes, I turned. I'm hoping I turned it off at this point. So let me know if you're still hearing the echo. Yeah, the animating is still not fantastic, but at least the sound is doing it okay.
Do you want to swap heroes?
They still have the echo. All right,
echo, they love the echo theme.
Logitech and Skype audio. Oh, wait, I think I know what's going on. Hang on a second.
You're still playing it from iTunes?
I am not playing it from iTunes, but I think I know what's happening. But I would be wrong. Really? They're still hearing the echo, huh? What about now? Let me know if you guys are still hearing echoes after I click that button. In a church, the Church of Sentinels. All right, so who was I playing? I was playing Legacy. Still Echo.
I said, let's switch up the heroes so we play each other's.
Ugh, you're going to make me play Nightmist?
Nightmist and Guys. That's right. So Guys is second. I guess I have to do that. Okay. So Spite has been defeated by this eclectic team, and no matter, Loomweaver is here. Is it just me, or does his pose on his card sort of give you kind of a hello, ladies, sort of?
All right, so at this point now, you guys should not be hearing any music. Tell me if that is accurate. Because I believe I turned the music off entirely, but I don't understand why it was echoing still. Echo gone. But is the music gone?
They still hear music.
Oh, excellent. Fantastic. Then I guess we fixed it. I won't be able to hear music, but that's okay.
Who knows? Do you want to take a look at Gloomweaver on advanced?
Oh boy.
Skinwalker Gloomweaver.
Alright, let's pop open. Oh, I'm trying to use my mouse to click on the video. That's not gonna work.
That doesn't work.
Alright, Gloomweaver, Skinwalker. We've got at the start of the game, Gloomweaver enters play Skinwalker side up. Pouch of Bones is put into play. The villain deck is shuffled. Gameplay. First time a non-villain target is destroyed each turn, the top card of the villain deck is played. When Gloomweaver would be destroyed, his villain character card flips to the Rotting God side instead. At the end of the villain turn, Gloomweaver deals the non-villain target with the second lowest HP H-1 melee damage, and in an advanced, increased damage dealt by villain targets by 1. Then when he flips to the Rotting God, we've got, when flipped to this side, Gloomweaver's maximum HP is 100. Gloomweaver is restored to 100 HP. At the start of the villain turn, Gloomweaver deals each target H infernal damage. That's every single target in the game, including himself. Whenever a cultist is destroyed, the top card of the villain deck is played. Whenever a target is destroyed, Gloomweaver regains 2 HP. At the end of the villain turn, Gloomweaver deals each non-hero target H-2 infernal damage. And on advanced, at the end of the villain turn, the top card of the villain deck is played. I don't know if I've ever played advanced Rotting God Skinwalker. I've played him regular.
Well, this team seems like it's ready for anything.
All right, let's see what we got.
I feel like Takedown is really good against him, and we also have Mistbound as an option, so.
Hello again, tiny mortals. Oh, man.
What?
The audio is glitching again. Oh, well. I tried.
Well, now we know.
Yep.
There are limitations.
There are limitations to the built-in streaming. All right, so let's do what I did the last time and turn the music down and put back this. So I guess that what that basically confirms is the game show is probably using the exact same mechanism.
I'm sure it is, yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's see what we got here. Legacy starts with Fortitude, Surge of Strength, and 2 Legacy Rings. Guys begins with Gritty Reboot. I can do that too. Retcon and Total Beefcake. Tachyon has a HUD Goggles, Hypersonic, Quick Insight, and Sucker Punch. And Nightmist has Call Forth, Mistbound, Oblivion, and Star Shield Necklace.
Cool. Pouch of Bones reduces damage dealt to zombies by 1, and on this side he is a zombie. Oh, and the Grimoire.
And the Grimoire comes out too. Oy. Oh, and yes, let's not forget, Nightmist is nemesis of Gloomy. All right, Legacy.
Oh, yeah, I'm controlling Legacy now. I forgot. So I do like to play Legacy Ring in hopes of getting another power. But I am going to play Fortitude right now. And would guys like to use a power?
I think guys always wants to use a power.
You could draw a card and potentially just use Tachyon's power, because I would want to use Tachyon's power, but I can't heal Tachyon.
Yes.
That seems like it could be a good little combo.
Oh, wait, I did that wrong. Stupid.
I thought you were going to play. Yeah, I can do that too.
Yeah, for some reason I thought that I had a power. Never mind. Where am I? We're going to go back to use a power. Right, okay, so use power. Then I want to play a card. Tachyon. Lead from the front. Retcon. Lightning Reflexes. Amulet of the Elder Gods. Now I can deal my damage. So. Mm-hmm. What does the Grimoire do again?
You have to discard or take damage. It's not as bad as the other one.
Yeah.
Pouch of Bones, I like to take out so that we can hit him more efficiently, but it is a lot of HP to get through, so
yeah,
sort of it's a crapshoot, really. Yeah.
All right. There's nothing for me to retcon. I guess I can total. I'll just total Beefcake, I think. What is Greedy Reboot? Dealt damage, draw a card.
Yeah, I would probably play Greedy Reboot.
Yeah. Let's get that card train going.
You have lots of points. Getting more cards is nice.
And there's my guys, the Barbarian. We'll hit the Pouch of Bones again. And I can do that too.
I really like that card.
I can do that too?
Yeah, you can do lots of cool stuff with it. All right, let's have some quick insight.
I can do lots of cool stuff with it, too.
Ooh. Got a bunch of neat cards. I'm going to discard Sucker Punch. And I probably want to discard a burst card, but I don't want to discard either of those burst cards. So Research Grant, I'm probably not going to use you for a while. Or ever.
Yeah.
Maybe later. I do use it later in games with this Tachyon because she has trouble discarding on her own sometimes, but depending on what you get.
Yeah, I feel like Oblivion is good if you know what's coming and you can set it up because you've got to get through a lot of hit points. So like a 1/4 would be ideal.
It's not easy to set it up with this Night Mist. That's the other Night Mist.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like I got a plan for the fact that we're probably going to have quite a few cards going to go around.
Yeah, so I mean, the amulet's good. You'll be able to discard for it.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
And of course, you can draw lots of cards because you're Night Mist. Just on your own.
Yeah, like, are we going to use. See, I don't want to get rid of either of those Oblivions because I want to imagine that I'm going to be able to use them well later.
You have full health. I wouldn't discard right now.
Yeah, that's fine.
Not for 2 damage.
Yeah. Mist of Time and Enlightenment.
Right now you are second lowest, depending on what the environment plays. Nope. Now Guy's is second lowest. I don't think order's really going to matter here. Even if we have some decisions to make, won't change any of the outcomes. Free card! Not free.
I can do that too.
You're going to get hit anyways, right? So. So here, we're going to get 4 minus the number of cards discarded damage from Gloomweaver. So if everyone discards 1, then it'll be 0. If there's anyone who absolutely doesn't want to discard something, then you don't have to. But I obviously can discard an extra Legacy Ring.
Discard any of these cards.
I would probably discard Extreme.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I mean, the unreducible is good, but
it's nice, those, but it's not the yeah.
Did I say unreducible?
You did.
Irreducible. It's unconceivable. Yeah, I'll get rid of one of these call forths, I think. Well, maybe.
Mist of Time?
Yeah, Mist of Time. I'm not going to use Mist of Time.
And with Advanced, he's got plus 1, so we still do take 1.
And she's going to take 2. And she's still over 20. Save it for later.
All right, guys can take this, I think, for a card. All-Stars asking, what does Skinwalker do in Advanced? Villain targets deal plus 1 damage on this side. I haven't been keeping an eye on the chat, but it's been pretty quiet.
Yeah.
Oh, and Chosen Disciple is looking for a zombie, but there were none. All right, I got another power. And on his flip side, he deals a lot of infernal damage. So I think starting to get the lead from the front next evolution combo is gonna be really good once we get him flipped. So I'm gonna get out lead from the front. And I think then I'm just going to go ahead and pass a power to Tachyon. Oh, look, Legacy has his stupid combo, says yep. All-Star 64.
Major Sense, best card ever comes out. Research Grants. Master of Magic.
I'll be using Blinding Speed on Tyler Hayes, by the way.
Okay, so I don't have to worry about retconning him?
Yeah, unless you want to retcon him. Like, you actually have 2 retcons.
I do have 2 retcons, so I could retcon him, and then I could retcon into Best Card Ever, and then I can do that, too. I could do that, too!
Is you have so many options.
Yeah.
Sometimes. I mean, well, anytime you consider that you're gonna be doing a bunch of damage, you want to think about having Guy's the Barbarian first.
Yeah.
Because remember, your power can let you play a card, so you can always get Guy's the Barbarian out first and then play a card.
So, like, retcon into Guy's the Barbarian, and then power into Best Card Ever?
Right. Yep, and then you could go look what I found as part of that. Like, yep. Yeah.
I like that. So we'll kill that.
Oh no, a zombie! Ugh, stupid.
Oh yeah.
all right, we can hammer the patch of bones down now.
And I'm going to play a card. So I'm going to guise the barbarian. And then we'll power into best card ever. Which draws, yeah, I'm that guy. And extreme. And we'll hit... I mean, Pouch of Bones is still our...
Yeah, I would... I usually try to destroy the Pouch of Bones. Woo! It can be really tough to knock him out with that constant minus one.
Yeah, so... Am I... Let's see, should I... Look what I found?
I would probably do that.
Yeah.
Max damage, Jeremy. Come on.
I hear you, man. So that's five.
And then you get another damage. Yeah, that's... You've done, like, 15 damage or so this turn.
Well, I guess 17.
17. That's pretty solid.
Yep.
And it's my turn. I think I'm going to use Nimble Strike. Let's see what I get. Hard goggles. Oh well. I have four burst cards. So I was thinking of doing a Hypersonic.
Lightning Reflex into Hypersonic and then Sonic Vortex, everything? That might be...
Yeah. Well, fun. Because it'll stop the Chosen Disciple from hitting us. It won't stop Gloomweaver because of the damage reduction. So it might be actually better to save the Hypersonic Assault for now.
Hmm.
Yeah, that's probably the case. So I think just Sonic Vortex... And that zombie is just, like, going to come back. So there's no actual need to hit it unless you accidentally hit it. That's fine. The Disciple will bring it back. And if you kill it, then Gloomweaver plays a card. So maybe don't kill it. Unless you really want to.
Yeah. But.
Pouch is down to eight. It's good.
See, this is the problem when you make me play Nightmist. I have to look at all these cards and reread them all and then still not have any idea what I want to do. Get a bunch of relics, or at least one relic.
Well, you would get... That's not what I want to vote for. If you played Call Forth, you could get four relics.
What I'm saying is I could, depending on what's on the top. Oh, it's not from the top. It's you discard a card. Aha.
Yeah. Yes, Lou Delphin points out that Gloomweaver can search his trash to get it back into play. But I think it'll probably make sense next turn to play Mistbound and then destroy his things.
Alright, so I know it's still only two damage, but at this point, is that pouch close enough that it'd be worth it for me to discard some of these multiple cards that I have?
Sure. Yeah, you've got a pile of cards, so.
Yeah. All right, so I just called forth, so I can get rid of the other one, I feel like. And then... If I want to get rid of one of these Tomes of Elder Magic, would you go for the higher or the lower
I generally try to keep higher magic numbers in my hand.
That's what I thought.
And that can sometimes trump like what the card actually is.
Yeah, totally.
Not bad. All right. Environment. Barrels again. Piles of barrels.
Barrels of fun. And the sheriff's going to come out.
And he's going to kill the zombie servant.
Look, sheriff, I know you've never seen a zombie before, but that pouch is actually more important. All right. I think both of my people have stuff I can discard, so...
Yeah. I have... I'm going to hold on to that lead from the front in case mine gets... I don't think mine can get destroyed, but I don't need two danger senses anyways.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get rid of Extreme again. They keep trying to bring it back.
And I can discard the HUD goggles.
And I'm going to get rid of my second Elder Ring.
And Legacy can just take this for zero.
Nice.
Yeah, let's save the amulet. I don't think, actually, he's not going to go after Night Mist. He's going to go after one of the environment targets. Indigo Pin. Discarding a card randomly. I feel like Tachyon is the most okay with that.
Sure.
And one of these barrels is going to be hit by a Gloomweaver. And yes.
And there's the zombie.
Unfortunately, that zombie came back and it heals everything. And Legacy can take it. All right. Next evolution. And melee is the main damage going around right now. So I'm gonna just do that.
All right, so I feel like we're still not looking to retcon away any of those things. What's gimmicky character again? Discard the top card of every deck. I could guise the barbarian into I could do that too into Legacy back to guise.
You don't have another power, though. It's kind of a waste. Right, you can only use your own power once a turn.
Right, that's what I said, is if I guise the never mind. Yes, you're right. Sorry. I always forget which of his cards let you play an additional card. Because I know, like, retcon does.
If you use Where Did I Leave That, you could get a best card ever back. Or you might just draw one.
Look what I found, and let me see that. Yeah, that's fine. I'll get back my best card ever. And I will play the best card ever. Gives me another retcon and another let me see that. Or not another let me see that because I got rid of the other one. So then I will hit the pouch of bones.
Woo!
And I will woo. Oh, I did not do that woo. It did it for me. I don't know if I was like breathing on the phone wrong or something. But that's okay. haven't yet done the damage from my base power yet, right?
No, that's right.
Because I'm still in my best card ever. So I could Guise the Barbarian and deal
an extra... just for a one-time plus two, though.
Yeah.
I would save it, probably.
So what do you think? I can do that two into Tachyon, maybe?
Well, into Legacy.
Into Legacy into
who can
Tachyon.
Then do Tachyon. Yeah, I would do that.
Yeah, let's do that. Thank you, Evil Dice Monkey. Says, if only there was handy icons on the bottom of the cards to tell you if they allowed it or not. Yes, that is a good point. I'm going to lean back in my chair a little bit, but I'm further away from the microphone.
All right. Keep chipping away at that pouch of bones, and hopefully we should be able to take it out. If we need to use Oblivion, we'll use Oblivion.
Jeez.
I do have a Lightspeed Barrage, so I think Tachyon can do it. Because I can hit it with a supersonic response and then a Lightspeed Barrage. Yeah. All right. So, supersonic to the Pouch of Bones.
Which gives you your fifth burst card, yeah?
Yeah.
Right.
And I'm thinking if I want to do a hypersonic this turn or not.
Yeah, so lightning reflexes, light speed, get that out of the way. And then hypersonic.
Yeah, I think I'll do that. There goes the pouch. Hypersonic. Just gonna hit these first in case something bad comes out when I destroy the zombie, or when I destroy the barrel, which is possible. And I hit Sheriff Pratt. Oh, but he's safe because of the cover. Excellent. It's a zombie, but the pouch is gone. There's your super ultra. And there's my fleet of foot.
What did it make you discard?
Blinding speed.
All right, so
yeah, I mean, it wouldn't hurt to get more set up or to just start going crazy.
In this case, going crazy is Oblivioning.
Yeah, or Heedless Lash or Oblivion.
Yeah, that's I was fine. Leaning on Heedless Lash because I know that's one that can sometimes give you something pretty neat.
The getting more set up would be like Master of Magic.
What have I got? Yeah, I'm gonna. So, what's our next? Now that we got rid of the Pouch of Bones, what's our next?
I would focus on Gloomweaver.
Gloomweaver, okay.
Because once he flips, he will destroy all of his other things.
Yeah. Alright, so I don't think I'm gonna. Yeah, but it's a four. So I'm going to get rid of that. And I've got another one of those. Take that to my nemesis.
Nice. Yeah, and you may as well play that. Could come in handy. You could even use it.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say.
Cost a discard, but we could avoid a fast following, potentially.
Yeah, I think I'm going to get rid of... I I mean, we're not going to need cards, so I feel like I can just get rid of Enlightenment.
I mean, you might need cards.
That's true. I don't know. I feel like
you're not going to need Mist Form for a while.
Yeah, that's true. I like that. We'll get rid of that.
I hope. Oh, good. Avoid the cursed acolyte. He's the worst.
Yeah. I mean, pins aren't great either, but definitely better than a cursed acolyte.
Yeah. Prickly cactus.
Ooh, is anybody doing lightning?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Yeah.
All right, this is Infernal, which Legacy is not yet immune to. So we'll probably want to discard.
So Sacruz says, I always seem to get rid of Elder Ring. Anyone else? I do too, because I can't get it out of my head that she deals herself damage for cards, and I don't want to boost it.
But when you're redirecting it.
Yeah, no, I know, that's true. But again, this is my problem with Night Misses. I can't think that many steps ahead to like...
I also often discard the Elder Ring. But it actually is more useful, I find, with Dark Watch Night Mist to play it.
What's my current HP? 19. I want all of these cards. Fair enough.
I'm not sure if you're going to really be using Let Me See That too much.
Oh, that's what I was just looking at. Okay, that's fine. I can get rid of that.
Oh, yeah, and he's Hypersonic Assaulted anyways. We didn't have to discard. I forgot. Want to go back?
Yeah, let's back it up.
Tekken might want to discard. I totally forgot that. The chat didn't even say anything. All right. Legacy skip. Guys can skip. Actually, yeah, I'll still skip. Oh, that was silly. It's a Sable Pin. And all of these melee damages will be redirected to Legacy for zero.
Lou Dolphin, thank you, sir. It's like it took him too long to type it out.
All right, I think I'm going to play the Legacy Ring so we can do more things. I can use Next Evolution to become immune to... Well, I think... Yeah, I mean, I could become immune to both Infernal and Melee, but we also have another Hypersonic Assault, so it doesn't really super matter. So I'm just going to Melee, I think, and we'll use Hypersonic Assault again. And do you want guys to do something? You can probably just do your things on your turn. We'll draw more cards. We love that.
Who doesn't like lots of cards?
I think it's time to put the hurt on. Destroy a card or Gloomer deals me damage, but he can't deal damage.
nothing really to retcon. I'm feeling like saying cheese.
And not then, super ultra.
Oh yeah, I guess. So remind me again. That's I can discard at the end of every turn to deal damage.
No.
Which one is
that? That one.
At the end of each hero turn, if you have more than four cards in your hand, you may play a card. Oh, I see. Okay. Okay.
That unkun kekya daza.
The blatant reference.
I just got the Japanese. All right. So then, oh, blatant reference is the discard to deal damage. Okay.
Yeah.
Say what again? Okay, so I'm going to... The question is, what am I going to play with my... I guess I could draw, and then I'll just have even more to play.
Yeah, I would probably do that.
Yeah, let's do that. Let me see that. And I'm just going to go after Gloomy. No, he is actually saying something in Japanese.
Yes. You should look in the forum thread. There are people talking about it.
All right, so I'm thinking I'll guise the barbarian and then use some of my other card plays to, like, say cheese. If we're trying to put the hurt on.
That works. Hypersonic Assault expires. All right, Fleet of Foot. Oh, we get Selling Out as well.
Nice.
And another Fleet of Foot, which I will play. Ooh, Inspiring Presence. You can double that one up. And I think I'm going to play Hypersonic. I think the order will matter.
Sanvar says, no guys the barbarian, you sad me that you didn't do that with tough choices. I got it out, though.
Yeah, but if you played it for, if you were planning to play it, you should have played it then.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Right. Well, yeah, no, that's a good point.
I didn't know you were planning to play it when you played it.
I don't know that I was planning to play it at that point.
There you go.
Again, that would require me thinking further ahead than one or two steps. And as we've
Sanvar is saddened.
I'm sorry, Sanvar.
Sanvar, you must be happy about what I did with guys in the previous game, though. That was pretty crazy. The cactus is so shocked by the hypersonic assault that it cannot poke Tachyon for punching an environment target. Everyone is sad. We're all sad. Finally, pushing the limits. Sitting here at full hit points.
Okay, so, based on what just happened now, say cheeses are one shots. What other one shots do I have? I have retcon, and I have I can do that too, and I have gimmicky character. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do here is actually play Selling Out. And then
I would play I would play Selling Out at the last possible moment.
At the last possible second? Okay. So instead I should play Where Did I Leave That and get two more?
I would do that. And okay, maybe get a best card ever.
Okay. I can get behind that idea. So I got another Say Cheese. And a look what I found. So I got all of the damage dealers.
I mean, keeping those is not a bad idea if you're planning to
I'm keeping those.
Do one shots on the on that turn.
Okay.
Actually, Mistbound might not be a bad idea because we're probably going to be losing some environment targets.
Discard two cards. If you do, you may select the deck cards, and that deck cannot be played.
And he plays a card whenever a non-villain target is destroyed. well, the first time each turn, and the environments are getting down pretty low.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
And you've got piles of cards.
Yeah. And that's the thing, even after we said that, I was just thinking I would actually play the Elder Ring after people were talking about it, but let's see. Should I get rid of the other... Draw that many cards? Yeah, see, again, Enlightenment is usually good. Oh, yeah, I do have two Scouring Mists. Okay, that's fine. I'll get rid of one of those. And we're gonna...
Black Gloomweaver.
Yeah, we're gonna bind Gloomweaver. And...
Then you don't need to scour his deck. You can just get more cards. Evil Dice Monkey is making a British joke. That doesn't mean the same thing in North America as it does over here. You've got piles. Does that mean anything to you?
It does not.
Piles is another word for hemorrhoids.
Ah, fun times. All right, so now I'm going to... Where is it?
Like Lou Dolphin asks, is there any reason to miss Bound a Hero? And Evil Dice Monkey says, yes, Ronway might be playing a hero. Yeah, selling out unless you wanted to. Yeah, I think it makes sense.
Yep. Temporal Event.
Yeah, so good thing we misbounded because these environment targets are going to be destroyed here. Does Tachyon want to discard a card? Nah. She doesn't really actually have that many cards. She plays her cards much faster than others. Oh no, lost in the past.
All right, so what is my maximum damage potential? I can look what I found into say cheese, say cheese, say cheese. No, it's well, two say cheeses if I discard.
So you're gonna discard, say, gimmicky character?
Yeah.
So I can do that too, is good because you can go to your base power. Well, you'd go to Legacy, and then Legacy would use your base power, or get you to use your base power, and then you could play a card.
So, yeah, so gimmicky character into yeah. I can do that too?
Well, gimmicky character, if you discard a one-shot, then you can play up to three one-shots.
Right. So I was going to... My initial thing from the damage-dealing school of thought was, look what I found, which is going to let me boost the next damage, which I can say cheese and then play a card.
And then yeah, say cheese I don't and think play a card. You can only play use the play a card on say cheese if the target that you hit is low enough.
Oh, five or fewer, right. Okay, understood.
You're not going to get to do that.
Yeah.
Unless you hit environment targets, but there's like that's not what we want to be hitting, so yeah. I don't think the order is going to really matter.
All right, so what you're saying was do that.
I mean, so if you just want to play say cheeses, then I wouldn't even bother using that. I can do that too.
Well, I could look play. What I found into I can do that too. Look what I found. Yes, yeah, so look what I found. They'll boost my next damage. Then I can do that too. Use my base power. Play, say cheese, with my base sure. power. Deal more damage with my base power. Then finish off with the say cheeses. All right. And we're going after Gloomy, right? Yes. Oh, and I have Guys the Barbarian in play.
Yeah.
All right.
You could use a retcon as part of this to destroy that sustain the portal also. Because it's going to hit us. And we are special snowflakes. So I'd choose Legacy.
Yeah, I was going to Legacy.
Legacy can bounce it back to Guys. Well, it's actually Guys using
bouncing
Legacy
it to
power.
Yeah.
Guys bouncing it back to himself.
All right, so what were you saying? I could use the retcon to get rid of the sustain the portal as one of these?
Yeah. You don't have to, but you could.
Well, you know, that, yeah, that lets me deal another card anyway, so...
Because sustain the portal's end of turn effect hasn't happened yet.
So now I can play a card.
So how is doing all this on a phone?
So far, so good.
Cool.
And the flash is working again, so that's good.
Cool.
And I get to play my last card, which will be another Say Cheese.
Nicely done.
Nice.
And he is hypersonic assaulted, I think. Yeah, or no, he can't play cards.
Yes, he's hypersonic assaulted.
Hypersonic, so yeah, we can skip the discard business. And he can't play cards, he can't deal damage, he can't do anything. Well, play a zombie from the trash. Oh no. All right. Legacy, what you doing? Inspiring presence time. And... So we're out of hypersonic assaults, so I think it's time to become immune to infernal damage. Which is good in case Nightmist tries to hit me also. And would guys like to use a power? That probably makes sense. You have plus one damage. Or plus, you have plus three damage now.
And I could always use my last Say Cheese.
Yep, not a bad call. Lunatic's Omen asks if this cross plays with Steam. I am on Steam. We are playing cross-platform right now.
Yep.
I have to destroy a card or Gloomweaver deals me damage. No, he doesn't. And you get to play a card. I probably wouldn't play a card.
I was going to say, there's nothing I want to play because they're all going to die. All right. All right. So, did I hear you say something about, yeah, I'm that guying and
yep. Getting you the... You do that, it'll copy, you can copy Legacy. Super great. There's a reason why that's the artwork. So now we have plus two to all damage.
I think I'm gonna... Is it worth it for me to total Beefcake, or should I just draw?
I wouldn't... Or you could use Blatant Reference.
I'm just going to draw.
Sure.
And I'm going to hit this.
All right. That's the end of hypersonic. And we'll use pushing the limits. And I guess synaptic interruption. And I kind of want to save blinding speed for something bad and there's nothing really bad. So, research grant. Sanvar was going to suggest using blatant reference. Well, that's okay. So you have plus two to damage with Night Mist coming up. Unfortunately, I didn't really have many damage cards, so that's why I don't have any cards, because the stupid pins are making me destroy my cards.
Yeah.
Oblivion would be pretty fun, but you do what you want.
Let me take a look at my deck real quick. So I've got... couple of fours, a bunch of twos, one, a couple threes. All right, so it's pretty much going to be a wild card if I have Oblivion.
Wild card!
I like a wild card every now and again.
A four and a three.
Four and a three.
All right, I think, yeah, the three. Well, here, if you order this right, you can optimize the amount of damage to him.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so hit him. I would hit... Gloomweaver with this one, and then Tachyon can redirect hers over to Gloomweaver, and he'll flip, and then we'll have him, then we can have everything else be destroyed and heal him now
while he's still at full.
Yeah,
nice. All right,
I guess we should have destroyed the Chosen Disciple first. That to reduce the number of card plays. You want to go back and do that?
Sure.
This is totally gaming the system.
Sometimes that's what you do.
Yeah, because we want to reduce the number of cards that he plays. And so he plays cards on the front side on non-hero targets, but he plays cards on the flip side on cultists. So yeah, let's destroy the cultist first. Actually, we can destroy the zombie as well. Then I think go after him. And Tachyon.
So there's a question, will the tablet, the phone version be a separate purchase from the tablet version? As with everything as it currently stands, the rules follow the rules of the store. So, and they will be universal binaries. So if you own the game for Google Play, any device that you have attached to your Google Play account, you'll be able to play Sentinels without an additional purchase. Same thing on iOS. If you have a phone and a tablet, it's one purchase for that store, and that is that. So I hope that answers the question.
I think it answers it to me. All right, let's let him destroy these targets. Because he will heal. But he's full. Aha. We did hit the sheriff before the cover cards. We are SMRT. It's amazing how the heroes can bend reality to make things take damage in a certain order. It's actually probably the most powerful superpower they have. So I don't think the order matters here, and you probably want to redirect that over to Gloomweaver. Though he might just heal it back. Actually, he won't heal it back. There's not that many targets, I don't think. He might. There's the pins. You might actually want to hit the Grimoire. I'd probably hit Gloomweaver, though.
Well, yeah, I was going to say. All right, let's see.
Because we know he's going to heal from the pins and the sheriff, actually. That's six. So if you hit him for six, he's just going to heal it. So it's not actually useful.
Grimoire it is.
And then, yeah, we'll have him hit the other targets first. Or this is the actually maximum damage to Gloomweaver by not hitting him.
Nice.
All right, so your choice here will be four damage for two cards or discard a card to look at his deck.
Well,
he's basically just going to be playing tons of cards no matter what, though. So.
Yeah. All right, shotgun to the end, I think. Oh. Except I already did that. That's fine.
What?
I hit myself to draw the cards because I forgot that I had already redirected for this turn.
Oh. I mean, it's still fine.
Yeah,
it's
fine.
I would have done it anyways.
Yeah, at over 20 hit points, that's fine. Wow, does Skinwalker Gloomweaver look cool on the phone? Yes. He like fills the space and he's like all on fire. Oh, that is cool looking. I hadn't seen that yet. That's very awesome. Good job, Jen. Jennifer actually had to rework almost all of the graphics to make sure that they looked good in the new layouts. And yeah, she did some good work there.
Cool. Well, he's actually not going to destroy anything here, so. Legacy's immune. That can be redirected. That can be redirected. Would you like to amulet this?
How much do I have? Yeah, I still have a ton of cards.
You have only 13 cards in hand. I don't know if you can spare any. And this is infernal damage, which we don't care about because Legacy can take it. Yeah, this team is pretty amazing against both these villains so far. But that's, I mean, once you pick those two, I pick the other two as ones that would work well with them against these guys. All right, I think the order is probably not going to matter here. Oh no, a Crimson Pin. Toxic damage. No. Guys could take it. Because he copied that. He's that guy. Tachyon is at full health. I think Tachyon can take the damage. All right.
Flying Smash killed the explosives barrel and watched
the world burn. Gloomweaver will do it on his own. So it doesn't really... don't really need to do that. I actually think I'll play Danger Sense and hide from the explosives wagon. And then I will use Next Evolution for Infernal. Infernal. And... guys can use a power.
You want me to make you immune to another... Oh, wait, no. This would make me immune to it?
Until the start of your turn, when that card
is... Oh, right, because it's... Yeah, it's the next. Okay, never mind. I was going to say, because we've got the explosives...
Just use your base power.
Wagon. Where did I leave that?
Yeah, I would probably play that.
I think that's what I'm gonna do.
There you go. Yeah, get another. Guy. Oh yeah, I'm that guy.
And a gritty reboot. Sure.
Good.
Good. That's right. I just want to see the world burn and explode. All right.
So if you play, oh yeah, I'm that guy, you will also be immune to the environment damage.
For liberty, truth, and Justin.
For liberty, truth, and Justin. God, so funny. Right, and so I'm going to be immune. Oh, wait a minute now. That's going to be the first time. Redirect the damage to the non-hero target with the lowest. Eh. All right.
I would probably play Blatant Reference. You're going to have lots of damage.
Yeah.
Like, that's four for every card discarded.
Hmm. This is a tasty burger.
Royale with cheese. I'm probably not going to use these Let Me See That's, right?
Probably not.
Yeah.
Unless you want to steal stuff from Night Mist, which is valid.
That would require me already knowing how to effectively use Night Mist and effectively use Guise, both of which I...
And the combination thereof.
Yes. Someday, I'll get there.
Do I want to take damage? Yeah. It's actually five. It's kind of probably not worth it, but that's okay.
We're not getting lost in the past today or yesterday. Nice. Circuse asks, will you guys continue to add guys isms as new content is added to the video game? There's certainly a potential for that. But I will reiterate what John said earlier in the stream, which is that you guys have still not discovered all the guys-isms.
It's true.
So it could be very well that, like, we don't add any more, but you guys are still discovering them a year from now. So.
And there are some in there that you can't get yet.
That is true. That is very true.
We planned ahead. There's a question for you.
There's a question for me?
In the game.
Oh, I was looking at the game trying to decide, and then you were like, there's a question for you, so I looked at the chat. yeah, I'm trying to decide if I want to take it or not.
I don't... Legacy can take it, I think.
How do you feel about Heedless Lash? Because, I mean, I feel like Oblivion I would want to do if there was more targets out. But there's probably not going to be a lot of opportunity with a lot of targets coming up still.
Yeah, I'm fine to let Gloomweaver destroy the wagon for us. So yeah. Heedless Lash is good.
Alright.
Or, I mean, you don't have to play Oblivion. But you kill it.
Yeah. and I'm still not gonna use that. Oh, Gloomy.
14 just from the Heedless Lash. I think you could play it.
Yeah, come on. Oh, I didn't even see. Oh, they must have been the same.
The same number.
Two threes. All reds. All right.
I don't think the order is going to matter.
Yeah, I don't think so either, but...
Actually, it does matter because you want to hit his things first and then the wagon.
Oh, good. So that's what I was doing, so good.
That's right. I forgot about the wagon, but yeah, you want to destroy the wagon so that the Oblivion is in plus one against us.
Three pair. You can't have three pair. You can't have six cards. Yes, that was... I actually own all three of those movies on HD DVD and Blu-ray. Because I was an HD DVD early adopter, and then Warner Brothers had like a... Show us your proof of purchase and we'll send you the Blu-rays. So when HD DVD died. So I actually have those movies on all the formats. I should fire up that old HD DVD player, actually. I have a
this
couple
is pretty
good
crazy
movies.
For a 2/2 Oblivion. But he's down to 25. I think you did like 50 damage to him or something. This turn. Maybe not that much. Like 30.
Oh man, I should have missed field recovery before that shuffle. Oh well. What are you going to do?
Eh. You still have 6 HPs. That's plenty.
Get rid of one of these.
Only 3 damage now. Oh well. And here's another wagon. Awesome.
It's that wagon you're dragging.
You want to send this back to Gloomweaver, I assume?
Oh yeah, I can do that.
You only have 12 cards to choose from, Jeremy. I don't know. Oh no, zombies.
Had to switch back to the music coming from the phone so that the right music kicks in when we win.
When we win.
Yeah, that's what I said. I said, when we win. I guess.
Fine if you want it.
I don't know. We're at that point in the game where I'm like, I'm just trying to push buttons to get to the inevitable, which is our victory.
I could choose Thak.
The correct answer was to flying smash him and something else and then kill the explosive wagon and then the game is over. But that's okay.
I choose Night Mist to destroy her nemesis instead.
Fair enough.
by investigating him. Who needs to be a master when you can go crazy?
All right, so I'm going to actually do this. Because this is just how I roll. What are you trying to hit? Oh, you're trying to hit me again? Come on.
This is what you get.
Nope. It's a stalemate. Fine.
Okay, you can have a hit Gloomweaver now.
You forking bastard. Such a waste.
Hey, you had victory in your hands.
I did, and then you voted it away.
You voted to hit the wagon instead of just hitting him.
And then instead of letting the wagon kill him, you let him get
becoming
all
immune to pants damage.
I chose the option that would deal more overall damage, John, which you should have known is what I would have done.
There you go.
And there it is.
That is a tasty burger.
Oh, he stabbed with his own obelisk. Proof, democracy doesn't work.
Well, it doesn't when there's two voters.
Yeah, no, there's no first past the post when it's 50-50. Nightmiss with one HP. Well played. All right. That was good stuff. Oh, wow. We actually went over 2 hours tonight.
Yep.
That's crazy. We never go over 2 hours, except on those few times that we do.
Special phone preview event.
Uh-oh. What happened? The music stopped again. I don't know why the music stopped. But anyway, it's after 9. So I guess that does it for another episode of Sentinels Live. Sentinels of the Multiverse is the only cooperative comic book card game that you and your friends should be playing. So thanks as always for joining us. We do this every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Sentinels, as you know, is currently available on iPad, Android tablets, and Steam. And as you saw tonight, it's coming soon to smartphones. And of course, if you don't have any electricity, it's always available in wonderful analog 16-color cardboard. And you can find more information about the game at sentinelsdigital.com. As always, I'm Jeremy.
And I'm John.
And that's us saying goodnight. We will see you next week.
Good night.
Night, everybody.